Hey there, this is Dr. A. Welcome back to my channel, and today I'm gonna be giving you 10 tips to avoid hair fall. Now, you might be thinking, this dude doesn't have great hair. What tips is he gonna give? Hey, that's hurtful. Just kidding. I went from losing around 30 to 40 hair per day to about 3 to sometimes on good days 0 hair follicles per day, and I want to get you there, so follow along. And you might ask, hey doctor, how will I measure how many hair follicles I've lost today? Do I have to pick up all the hair follicles that I've lost and count them up? Absolutely not. I'm gonna give you a simple test that you can perform at home to know how many hair follicles you lost per day. All you need is a comb like this, something that's not too fine, this is like a medium tooth comb, and a book or a sheet of white paper to measure how many follicles have fallen on it. And how to do this test, I'll show you now. So what you're going to do is sit somewhere comfortable, get this white sheet of paper or a book or something, get your comb ready, and just lean over the sheet of paper and comb your hair for 1 minute continuously. Not any rough strokes, but just gentle strokes leaning on the paper. So after a minute, just see how many hair follicles there are on the sheet of paper. That's how many you lose on an average per day. Obviously, don't do this test every day, because when you're rubbing it, you are prone to lose quite some hair. So do it like once a week to see the progress that you are making from a week to week. Let's now jump into the hair fall tips, 10 tips by Dr. A, starting. Tip number one, do not wash your hair every day. Hair has a fine layer of oil on it, which acts as a humectant to keep the moisture locked on the hair. If you wash it out by taking shower every day, it just washes out those oils. What happens is your hair becomes dry, and dry means brittle hair. Brittle hair means hair fall. Now, you might ask me, doctor, I have a friend with great hair. He showers every day. He uses the harshest chemicals, the harshest shampoos, the harshest hair colors possible on his hair, but he still has great hair. How is that possible? Genetics. He has great genetics and he has great hair. You probably don't have great genetics like me when it comes to the hair, and that's probably why you're watching this video. So my friend, you don't have that great genetics, so your hair is prone to damage, and you can cause a lot of damage to your hair by washing it every day. So don't do that. But you might ask, doctor, if I don't wash my hair every day, it becomes smelly, it becomes very oily and all that. That is probably because you have an oily scalp, and that's a problem that has to be rectified, and I'll tell you how to do that down the way. Step 2, use clean water to wash your hair. If possible, actually use the water that you use to drink to wash your hair. Now, let me stop you there. You might think, this guy is crazy. What is he saying? Use drinking water to wash hairs? Like, you could give it to kids in Africa. Sure, you could do all that, but if you want to save your hair, trust me, my barber gave me this opinion, and I thought that was outlandish when he first told me. But then I came home and I actually tried it for a week, and I saw a huge difference, and I'm pretty sure you will see too. So wash your hair with drinking water. Why drinking water? Because the water supply that you probably get is hard water, or like mixed water. And hard water, what it does is the calcium deposits can sit on your scalp, and that can dry up your scalp, and a dry scalp and dry hair means hair fall, and that's why you should use clean and drinking water to wash your head. Step number 3, do not comb too often. When you're combing too often, especially with a fine comb, what it does, it tugs on your hair follicles, and since your hair follicles are already quite weak and fragile, it can actually pull them off and lead to hair fall. Also, do not keep running your fingers through your hair. Like, probably when you're working, you probably will be scratching your head and all that. It's a subconscious event. Your hand just goes there, and you just want to scratch your hair when you're thinking. But consciously make an effort to stop doing that. It'll make a huge difference, trust me. And tip number four, avoid using hair products like wax, cream, gel and all that. This is a cardinal sin when it comes to hair care, wearing hair products for too long. But you may ask, doctor, I have this photo shoot, I'm getting married today, or my ex broke up with her boyfriend and I really want to go out and celebrate and I want to wear that hair product. Sure, go on, wear it. But for Christ's sake, once you come back home, please take a shower before you go to bed. Do not leave it on. Do not get up next day and forget to wash it. That'll definitely damage your hair. Come back home, wash it and sleep. But try to avoid the use of hair products as much as possible. Please do not use it every day. Your hair should be the way God made it or evolution made it, whichever theory you want to believe in. Just leave it clean, wash your hair properly and leave it. That is all you need to do about your hair. Tip number five, get a hair massage, a gentle hair massage once in a week. Now hair massages are great because it increases the amount of blood flowing to your scalp. It stimulates hair follicles, it stimulates the scalp to have better circulation basically. And it also feels nice. So have someone to give you a gentle massage, not vigorous massage, just a gentle massage with a bit of oil or something. That should be really good. Tip number six, after a head shower, do not rub your hair vigorously. What you should be doing is with a clean towel, just pat your hair dry. And that's all you need to do. You don't need to, you know, rub it vigorously and, you know, get it to become as dry as the Sahara Desert. No, you don't need to do that. And also, when you have a hot water shower, like I like to do not rub or pat your hair right after the shower. Just wait for a minute or two, let the hair settle, let the temperatures decrease. When you use hot water, the temperatures are quite high, right? Like when you put hot water, what it does is your hair becomes quite fragile when it's exposed to such heat. So if you rub it right away, you're gonna lose your hair. So that's something you should avoid. Tip number seven, avoid blow dryers at all costs. Now these hair dryers, it just hurts me to think how much damage it does to your hair follicles. Just so much heat, so much physical force tugging at your hair, just blowing it all with so much force. That's definitely going to hurt your hair follicles and cause minute breakages, which will cumulatively lead to hair fall. So in case if you really need to use a blow dryer to, you know, style your hair or something, what you can do is get one of those heat protecting sprays, just spray it on your head everywhere and then use the blow dryer. And then after that, use some product which actually, smoothens your hair, cools it down and works as a calming agent basically. Tip number eight, do not use a shampoo every time you shower. Shampoos will dry out your scalp and your hair like crazy. Unless you have a job where you have to, you know, clean toilets with your head, don't imagine, it's gross. Or if you're a minor, like M-I-N-E-R, not the below 18 years kind. If you have a job like that, okay, go on, use shampoos, you probably really need it. But if you have a regular job, you don't really need to use shampoos. There's not much in your hair that needs cleaning like that. But you may ask, doctor, how else am I gonna, you know, clean my hair? Isn't it gonna be dirty? Just water is not gonna be enough. Yes, I've got a simple trick up my sleeve. Wanna know what? This is just a conditioner. Basically what you can do is use your conditioner as your shampoo and it works really well, trust me guys, and it avoids hair fall. It's easy on your hair and scalp. And use this for a month, any conditioner that you're comfortable with, use it for a month and you'll definitely see a difference in your hair fall. Trust me on this guys, I'm pretty sure you'll see a difference. I use this one from Forest Essentials. This is not a sponsored post. I like their product, especially this one. I didn't like any of their other products. I've tried 2-3 other, I didn't like them. This is amazing. This has got amla, honey and muleti in it. This is good on my scalp and hair and I've been seeing really good results with this. I'll put a link in the description below if you want to buy that. Step number 9, put on oil masks at least once a week. You can either make an oil mask or put on coconut oil or something before taking a shower, just a bit. Or what I do is this special form. This, it looks dirty but it works. This special formulation made by my mother. It's basically pepper and curry leaves heated with coconut oil. And as you can see, the pepper and the curry leaves are still there, and I just keep this in this bottle and use it every time before I take a shower. What it basically does is pepper and the curry leaves, they're irritants, so they're mild irritants. What they do is when you put it on your scalp, it causes mild irritation of the scalp, not enough to cause hair fall, but enough to increase the circulation to your scalp. So you put that on, circulation increases and it nourishes your hair follicles. That's how it works, and it really does. Try it out. So tip number 10, or this is like a point number 10, oily scalp can be a huge problem and it needs to be rectified. Oily scalp can actually increase your hair loss. So, and it can also predispose you to a lot of fungal infections, and it's just dirty, it smells, it stinks, and it's just not healthy. So what you can do is, my father, who's also a physician, he recommended this to me. He personally used it for a few months, and I use this once in a month or something now. Basically what you do is, when you start with this, you use it for 2 times a week. You just, like, you know, wash your hair, use this as your shampoo for 2 times a week for a month, and after that, after that 1 month, you can use it as a shampoo like once a week or something, based on how oily your scalp is. If your scalp is not too oily, you can probably, you know, stop using this. But if you, you know, see that your scalp's kind of oily or something, you can use this. This is called AFK. It has ketoconazole and zinc pyrithione. I'll put a link down in the description below. This is amazing. You should definitely try it out. And a few general tips to go along with that. One thing that you can do is you should reduce stress. Stress plays a huge, huge role in hair fall. When I was in final year of my med school, I had like a huge level of stress because obviously I had a lot of things to complete. I had a lot of assignments to do. I had a lot of books to finish studying, and a lot of tests and all that. You get the idea. I had a lot of work on my plate. So that was stressful, and I lost a huge, huge, huge number of hair every day. I used to lose around like 30 to 40 to 50 hair follicles per day. It was a bad period. So do anything that you can do to avoid stress. Meditation, get regular exercise. That is definitely gonna help preventing hair fall. So those are the general lifestyle tips that you can use to significantly reduce the amount of hair fall that you notice, the amount of hair fall that's actually happening every day. If you want me to make a video about all the medical things that you can do, like the tablets that you can take, the interventions, the surgeries that you can undergo to prevent and to treat hair fall, let me know in the comment section below, hashtag AskDrA, and I'll try to make a video on it soon. And I also know that a lot of you guys have a problem with dandruff. So if you want me to make a video on it as well, let me know in the comment sections below. It was great talking to you all. Till I see you again, stay happy, stay healthy. Cheers.